Hello. I am doing my own version of prepping for planner season. If you see a fly go past in the screen, know that it has been driving me crazy for about an hour and a half and I can't catch it with my racket. The first thing I started to do was I started taking this A5 Hobonichi notebook. Not sure if you can see this, but I'm just kind of mapping out the calendar in here. This one with the pink crosses is going to be social media. I'll put the thumbnails that I mentioned in my last video. And this one with the blue, I really don't think you're going to be able to see this, will be the monthly ink log. And then from daily, I'm going to start doing kind of daily pages like I was already doing my ink log. So I'm prepping that. I'm hoping to get it done before I see all the planner things. This is all to keep me from pre-ordering. And then I have decided I'm going to take this Sterling Ink 2024 planner that I had was going to use for my health planner and cut it along this signature. I think I'm going to use this, which is kind of like a cardstock collage book. It's called The True and the Questions, a journal. I think you're supposed to write in it, but I just kind of use it for collage paper. So I'll do like this for the cover. And I don't know whether that's going to fit. I think it should because it'll only be this thin. Yeah, so I'll cut that out. Oh, this fly. I've got some bookbinding tape in case I need it. Some of these pages from where I'm cutting along this signature will be dated, and I don't want the dates. So I have done one attempt where I used this tape, which is pretty much exactly this color. I taped it on a piece of sticker paper and then I punched it out with just, a regular old hole punch. And that covers them, but then it makes these like bumps. I only need to do it, whatever I do, redating until here. And then the rest of it's blank. And so what I'm going to do is I'm just going to have entries every time I read a book. Or do some neat project. Have not made a full decision on exactly what things I'm going to be putting in here, but it'll be better than what I was doing in my project weeks, which was just putting one thing down and having the rest of the whole thing be blank. I'll just use both sides. So I want to cover these so I could just use a date stamp. I have a bunch of different correction tape options. So I will be trying that out on the previous pages just to see which one works best and make a decision on it. This I could probably, I don't know, cover on the day, but I just want to cover all these little ones. And then this I'll just put a sticker or paint on it with an acrylic paint stick or just something. Yeah, so this is my plan. And I will pause and get my cutting tools because I forgot those. I think I will need some end papers as well. Look at all those health stickers I made for no reason because I'm not using them. I'll just put them aside in case I do decide to use them again sometime at a later date. Yeah, so I'm wondering because the end papers in this Sterling ink are just pretty plain. So I could just get. I had a couple ideas. I brought up. At one point, I had a thought I would color with colored pencils. I've never done it. This one is from Flying Tiger. This could be kind of cute. Just having a different little cityscape in the front and the back. Just to, Or we have whatever this coloring book for adults is. It has big kind of double pages. Yeah, I don't even think, I think somebody gave this one to me. I wish there were two pages of this. I don't know why I like that. But yeah, I could pick this one with numbers. I was trying to think of something, I don't know. I'll pick one. We'll decide later. And then this one, which is the Tula Pink coloring book, which I was actually thinking of just selling instead. Because somebody's probably going to want this. And I have not touched it. Did I buy it? I have no idea. I'll probably sell that. So it'll be one of the other two that I pull papers out for. So, okay, I took off the cover and took it out of the plastic cover. And then, let's see, I need to, I just went and got the cutting things. Okay, here's my cutting things case, which I have everything except for a oh no, you know what? This might be a regular. Let's see. Yeah, this is like a little teeny X-Acto. That should work. All right. First, oh, I'm so indecisive. Okay, I should get my cutting board out, shouldn't I? But I'm not, because right now I'm in, let's just do something mode. I have been stuck in my room. Today is Saturday. I've been stuck in my room since Monday with COVID, so that I don't get anybody else, anywhere else, sick. And I'm losing it. I'm beginning to lose it and come up with crazy plans. All right, so we've got that. There's some serious gluage going on back here. All right, I think I do need my cutting mat. I will pause again. It is insanely muggy over here. All right, should I just get some scissors? Now that I got my cutting mat. Well, whatever Sterling ink makes these covers out of, it's tough. So there's that. Okay, there's the dead bits. Should we try out these things? So these two are both Midori correction tape. I don't know whether there's anything different about them. I think somebody told me that they were cream color, and then they weren't, like, to work in the Hobonichi weeks. That one looks all right. Yeah? Let's try this other one. But these are like the little mini ones. This just looks like it's exactly the same color. Oh, but it's, I hate correction tape sometimes. You could press it down though. All right, and then, so that works. What about this Tombow one? If these ones are matching, then I know that this one, which is the cream color for the weeks, won't work, which is good because I only have one. And I will be using weeks again. Ugh. Okay, so any one of these, I think, will be fine, as long as I just do the same color every day on the paper. Should I get my stamp out? Let me get my stamp out. Ow. Where is it? Apparently we're pausing. Okay, we have a date stamp. This is, what, 20, not 36. 26. using this Shachihara. Because I got, did you know that they sell like a refill stuff for this? I just got one to refill my black ones. I'm thrilled with it. So I will do something like this. And I'll put maybe the picture of the book over there. And then I'll just write about it. I think that's what I'm going to do with this. All right. And then just maybe put a decorative washi or something along there. That will go in this half. So I need to get... Oh, is that that stupid car? We have a car parked somewhere out there whose alarm has been going off every day, probably every hour, maybe. And I feel like this is a plot to drive me absolutely insane because, you know, stuck in my room. Where'd I put the ruler? Here's the ruler. And it's, you can hear that the alarm is kind of dying now. I don't know whether it's like a stolen car that somebody's just abandoned on our road, but this person is going to be very surprised when they come back to their car and it's dead. If not. All right, so that covers off. So I had asked a lot of people on Simone's Discord, because there's a few people on there that do bookbinding. So I'd asked them, you know, how to make it hardcover. And it all looked like more work than I thought I would actually do. And what I'm trying to do with this is do something I can do probably quickly enough to keep me from being tempted by all the planners when they come out. Trust the process. Or trust the mess. That's more me. Okay, so let's cut this page out. And I think this is big enough, this page. We'll find out. If not, I'll use it for something else, won't I? Cute on the other side. I wanted to put a city on it, but that will well. I was gonna do it this way, right? So trust the mess, kinda. Trust the mess is gonna end up on the back, isn't it? No, it'll be on the front. All right, I'm gonna go figure out. I think it's actually gonna work, guys. I just have to fold the spine. All right, I'm gonna go figure out dimensions and stuff and do some creases on the spine. Should I? Yes, I'm gonna do that first. All right, guys. Yes. Okay, and then what was it? Seven. All right. Five. looks a bit wide, doesn't it? That looks a bit narrow. All right. Might have to wing this. Might have been too narrow. Oh, I just cracked it. Okay, this is going to be done a little bit differently. But that actually is probably better. I'll just... What was that? So if I do, glue that to there, let's see if I can bend this without cracking it. Yeah, I went way too far in the, that collage book does not, does not crease very well. I should have had a lighter touch. But I want this trust this mess. Or trust the mess. Alright, if I leave a little bit, if I glue it so it just covers the edge of this a little bit, if I can make that work, I think I'm going to have to, what would it look like? Yeah, you'll still get what it says, right? Alright. I'm going to pause. I'm going to do this off camera because it's nerve-wracking and I'm also sweating because of the freaking humidity. All right. All right. I've decided I will. So I keep my super insanely thin tape, double-sided tape in here. So I decided I will do this on camera, but I will speed it up for you. That is crooked as bleep. I think it might be my scissors that suck. I'm such a scissors snob too. These have done me well for so long. All right, this is crooked, but we're going for kind of a punk rock handmade vibe, so that is okay. All right, this edge is a bit jagged. I totally did that backwards. So the majority of the tape it was supposed to be on the back, not the front. But you can still see that it kind of says, trust the mess, right? Yeah, sort of, no. All right. And then I think I need to pick what I'm gonna put on the inside. Should I cut it down before that? No, I'll cut it down after that. This like just covers it. Okay. All right. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to glue kind of like an in page on either side to this and to this. I am doing this all wrong, by the way. Don't follow this. Just watch it and laugh at me. Like, watch real bookbinders. The people who gave me advice, like Laura from Blue Rosary, they're going to be horrified when they watch this, if they watch this. Maybe I'll tell them not to watch it. All right, I'm going to go pick out an inside. And then, yeah, figure that out. Okay, I'll be back. All right. I picked one and then I changed my mind. So I've got to take this next one out. I think this is long. Ugh, I didn't do it well. Anyways, I've got two sides of this so I could have matching back and front if I didn't just screw that up. Trying to do this with a camera like right above you is not easy. But I'm also in reckless mode, so I don't know whether you can tell. All right, so yeah, I think this will work. I feel like I should be cutting it at this point. Got this. Oh gosh, just. I screwed it up, but I just am gonna get away with it. All right. Should I glue it to the book first and then glue it in? And I think I'm gluing it, yeah, all the way to here. I better not forget that. Okay. Glue to the book first. All right. Glue stick and glue stick guy. All right. Pause. All right. You guys have all seen my gross glue book. So, let's see. Glue sticking, because I'm just more comfortable with glue stick. You have a little bit of time to move things with a glue stick. All right. Except for you get glue all over you, and I hate that. I did a fantastic job. Where's this? All right. Well, this isn't professional. This is just going to be serviceable. I'll feel good about myself for reusing things instead of buying new things and all that stuff. So this is, yeah. That is the worst gluing job I think I've ever done in all my days. Look at it. Can I fix this? Gluing things to Tipperary River, not my favorite. All right, we're gonna lose another page. Cause I've gotta fix this. I can't look at that. Nope, nope, nope. There'll be a lump, but you won't see it as much if I just sacrifice one more page. See? Not as bad. Not good, but not as bad. All right, let's try the other side. And hopefully we do a better job of things. So it goes this way, right? All right, because this has a stiffer page on it, this will probably go a whole bunch better. Let's hope. Because that was really embarrassing. Yep. Way better. Okay. It's only the front that I'll see all the time that will be terrible. All right. And then oh, where's my glue thing? Turn the page so I don't stick the front down to anything. Okay, so I'm not gonna glue the spine on, I don't think. I mean, it's not totally horrible. And I have a monster cutter, so what I will be doing is I was supposed to do that a little bit further down because now I'm going to have to round every corner. No, no. Yep, I'm going to have to round the corners more. Damn it. Okay. Can you tell I'm just totally freaking winging this? Actually, I did give it a bunch of thought. You just can't tell. All right. Heavy book. I think I will glue down the back and then I will put it under a heavy book and we'll come back later. All right, we're gonna put it under a heavy book. I will go down to the paper cutter. I'll cut it, but then show you what that looks like. Then I'll do the corners. I'll show you what that looks like. And yeah, do I have a heavy book? What's this? Okay, see ya probably tomorrow. Okay. Here's the finished product. I don't know why, but I think it's so messed up, I actually really like it. So that's supposed to say, trust the best. I had to put the tape on the spine. Of course, I did this on the wrong side. So the skinny part was supposed to be on this side, so you could still see it said, trust the mess. But I think I still can tell that it says, trust the mess. Basically, this I think is supposed to say ache, but it looks like acne to me, which I think is really funny. Here's the inside papers. It doesn't look as bad after having the book sit on it for a while, but like if you look there, it's kind of warped and crumpled, and I don't care. Matching front and back. And I had to cut some off of the edge. My cutter, I hadn't cranked it down enough so that it was holding it in place well enough, and so it did a really bad cut the first time, so I had to cut a little bit closer, but you can still see the page numbers, so that's fine. This is fine. This is good enough. This will be something I can use for my books and whatnot for next year. I think what I might do, instead of covering each one of these dates, is print the pictures. Where is that planner? Right. So print the books on solid sticker paper and just stick them over them. So that way I don't have to go through and cover them all. And then I'll just put the date somewhere over on this side, I think. Basically, this is the lazy way of repurposing a planner. The lazy chaos planner massacre way of doing it. So that is what I'm going to use for the project planner next year. And I won't have a bunch of empty bits like look, that's all this empty space. When I'm really just wanting to track, you know, finishing a book or doing a project or something like that. And so I could just do it. If it's considered undated, I could just do it in each spot every time I do something and date the spot. So kind of like Simone is doing, but different. And I'm reusing the end of this Sterling Ink common planner. It's vaguely the same size as a Hobonichi Weeks. Let me see, does the cover go back on it? I mean, I probably won't put this cover on it because this cover has like a pattern, but I am so uncoordinated today and I really shouldn't have been trying anything like this. Like, I tried to fold a fitted sheet. I've been stuck in my room all week long, so I decided to watch videos on YouTube on how to perfectly fold a fitted sheet. I decided I'm 55 years old. It's time I learned this. Instead, I just ended up getting in a horrible rage and feeling uncoordinated. So I decided to try and do something else that requires coordination. Okay, there's a bit too much hanging off the edge, but so I probably won't put it in that, but I'll just put it back inside the leather cover and use that for something else at some other time. There we go. Trust the mess, everybody, because I'm the mess. See? Thanks. Bye.